The doors only opened for people who could pay. And for Suzanne Pringle at the Texas Fair Defense Project,
the procedures that were in place in Harris County were not cutting it.
It's been a years-long legal battle after the civil rights group filed a case against the county on behalf of three low-income plaintiffs charged with misdemeanors who couldn't come up with enough cash to pay for bail.
The theory of the case is that it is a violation of equal protection rights to hold someone on bail that they can't afford.
And this week, the Fifth Circuit of Appeals agreed in an opinion that could have statewide implications.
Counties in Texas are already thinking about what they can do to be more fair. And this ruling says to counties, we can't automatically assess bond. We actually need to have a hearing. We actually need to consider ability to pay.
Meanwhile, those in the bond industry say it's a win on their end as well.
The ruling, in our view, upholds the use of preset bond amounts.
Some say the court's opinion gives the bond industry a stamp of approval, but bondsmen still say they want more guidance from state lawmakers rather than following regulations from county to county.
There has to be a standard established, and I think that's what the legislature is going to work on this upcoming session.
Both sides agree it's a step toward equality, one they'd like state lawmakers to build on. Max Gordon, Spectrum News.